condition has continued through the church dispensation, and it will continue into the tribulation period that we're getting ready to read of until the middle of the tribulation period after the preaching of the two witnesses, Elijah and Moses, that we will read about tonight from the 11th chapter of the book of Revelation. It will be through the preaching of these two witnesses that Israel or our Jewish brethren will have their hearts turned back to God, and they will come to the knowledge that Jesus is the Messiah, and they will then at that time, among them 144,000 will have their foreheads sealed, and after they are sealed, 12,000 from each of the 12 tribes of Israel according to the 7th chapter of the book of Revelation, then they will be caught up to God after the two witnesses are caught up to God. And then of course there is a remnant of Gentiles that will be saved in that first half of the 7-year tribulation period. And that is referred to as the number which no man can number in the 7th chapter of the book of Revelation, of every kindred, tongue, nation, and people. Or every nation, kindred, tongue, and people. However you want to say it is fine with me. There will be many and multitudes that will be saved among the nominal churches, among our Gentile brethren, during the first half of the tribulation period. And so some have taught that no one is going to heaven but those who are baptized in Jesus' name and filled with the baptism of the Holy Spirit. And this is false teaching. The Bible does not teach that. It has never taught that. The message for this day is the gospel. One can only be saved in this day through the gospel of, someone say, Jesus Christ. The gospel of Jesus Christ is the death, burial, resurrection, and ascension of Jesus Christ. The fulfillment of that gospel is repentance, fulfilling his death. Baptism, fulfilling his burial. Receiving the baptism of the Holy Spirit with the evidence of speaking with other tongues as the Spirit of God gives utterance, fulfilling his resurrection. And we shall fulfill his ascension when the Lord descends from heaven with a shout, the voice of the archangel and the trump of God, and the dead in Christ rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so shall we forever be with who? I can't hear you. And so now, the reason why we have a chance today at the wonderful and marvelous salvation of Jesus Christ, or God in Christ, is because the Lord, according to verse number 10 of the 29th chapter of Isaiah, hath poured up out upon the Jewish brethren, the nation of Israel, the spirit of deep sleep, and have closed their eyes. The prophets and your rulers, the seers, have he covered. He has covered their eyes, and he will not open them again until the church has been raptured. And the two witnesses, Elijah and Moses, both which are descendants of Abraham or Abram, both which were prophets of the Old Testament order, they have a job to do. And their job will be done and completed by the end of the first half of the tribulation period. Are you listening to me? And so now in verse 11, I will reread it in your hearing. And the vision of all is become unto you. The you is our Jewish brethren, as the words of a book that is sealed. Someone say sealed. When God seals something, I will say it again, no one can open it but God. Does it make any difference how you search it out? You won't find it. Because the only way that you can find out anything that God wants you to find out about him, about his word, about his knowledge, his understanding, his wisdom, is by divine revelation. Are you listening to me? And of course, it is the glory of the Lord to reveal a secret. But it is God that keeps things secret, and he is glorified when he reveals it. Or it is, of course, us that glorify God when we search a secret matter out and God decides to reveal it to us. Are you listening to me? Now then, it says, in the vision of all has become unto you as the words of a book that is sealed, which men deliver to one that is learned, saying, read this. I pray means I ask thee. The term pray translated in English would be, I ask thee. And of course, and he saith, the learned one says, I cannot, for it is what? Someone say sealed. Now, it doesn't make any difference how much education one may pursue. The things of God can only be known by divine revelation. If he does not reveal it, then we will never know it. Are you listening to me? So now, the secret things, one scripture says, belong unto the Lord. But the things that are revealed belong unto us and to our children. Someone say children. This is found in the Old Testament. Can the church say amen? So when God reveals something, he expects us to first of all receive it. Then after we receive it, we are to then take it and teach it to our, someone say children. And this is the reason why I'm teaching tonight, is because as the father of many of you in the gospel, that I am teaching you as the children of God. Because this is what God's order is. Are you listening to me? This is the order of the Almighty God. What's his name? Now then, verse number 12, and the book is delivered to him that is not learned, saying, read this, I pray thee. And he saith, I am not learned. Wherefore the Lord said, for as much as this people draw near me with their mouth and with their lips do honor me, but have removed their heart far from me, and their fear toward me is taught by the precept of men. This has been a problem with our Jewish brethren and many in the nominal churches for almost 2,000 years, two millennials. The fear of God has been taught by the precept of men. And men have taught God's fear by their own precepts rather than by the principles of God found in the scriptures, because the things in the scriptures have been hidden from them. And their eyes have been closed. And because their eyes have been closed and God has not opened up their understanding, then it should be clear to each and every one of us, this is why they have been unable to teach the principles of the doctrine of Christ and the precepts of God through right division, inasmuch as they do not have the divine revelation. Are you listening to me? And so now he says, verse 14, therefore, behold, I will proceed to do a marvelous work among this people, even a marvelous work and a wonder, for the wisdom of their wise men shall perish, and the understanding of their prudent men shall be hid. And so this then lets us know that you cannot then understand God's word with your own wisdom. Are you listening to me? And you cannot come to understand anything regarding God when he has hidden those things from the wise and prudent. The 11th chapter of St. Matthew. I thank thee, O Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because thou hast hidden these things from the wise and prudent and hath revealed them unto babes. Who are the babes? Those who have been born again of water and spirit, born into the New Testament church through the new birth experience. And I was glad to hear of the sister today that came and was baptized in his name and filled with the baptism of the Holy Spirit even before these services take place. Now she has come into the church. I have not had the pleasure of meeting her, but now she has come into the church, and she is a babe in Christ. And now what God has for her and for any individual that comes into the church through the new birth experience is divine revelation. The first thing you should desire after being born again is, as the scripture says in 1 Peter chapter 2 and verse number 1 and verse number 2, as newborn babes, you are supposed to desire the sincere, or the pure milk of the word of God, that ye may grow thereby. And what is that milk? According to the 6th chapter of the book of Hebrews, that milk is the principles of the doctrine of Christ. And I may add that according to the 5th chapter and verse number 12, and subsequently chapter 6 and verses number 1 through 3, that is, and in there is found, the milk of God's word. The principles are referred to as the oracles of God. Can the church say oracles? Oracles. The principles are also referred to as the milk of God's word. And after we come into those principles, which are found in Hebrews chapter 6, verses number 1, 2, and 3, which are repentance from dead works, faith toward God, the doctrine of baptisms, laying on of hands, resurrection of the dead, and eternal judgment. Then we leave those principles, the scripture says, and go on to perfection. And this will we do, the scripture says, if God permits. That means if God puts us in a position where we have access to the teaching and or revelation. That's why it is of paramount importance. If you are in a church where you are not receiving what you need and what is necessary for your perfection, that you get out of there and get where you can get what you need if you are not receiving what you need to be perfected in Christ. Now, that's no reflection necessarily on that church that you're in, but it is no different than being educated. And one of the greatest things done under the Engler administration is the passing of legislation known as school choice, where parents were given the authority and the privilege and the power and the ability and the flexibility and the freedom to take and make the decision as to where their children would be educated, in the public school system. Thereby, if they would take then this responsibility and hold their children accountable as well as the public school educators, then they would evaluate these educational institutions of higher learning and education based on their performance in instructing and teaching and educating and graduating these students and helping them to pass the MEAP test. Now, many people don't believe in the MEAP test, but you have to have some standard wherewith you measure one's ability to learn and one's level of knowledge of learning. And there are some schools that are better than others. Now, I sit on a board with the Honorable Dick and Betsy DeVos. These are members of the founders of Amway. You may know that Dick DeVos Sr. and Jay Vanando are the founders of Amway. Well, I sit on a board known as Choices for Children, of these distinguished personalities. And there was an evaluation done by the Anderson Group in which they evaluated some 523 school districts across the state of Michigan. And in their evaluation, they found that 480 of the 523 were not succeeding at graduating 75% of juniors from the 11th to the 12th grade with successful MEAP scores. And so there were some concerns, great arguments broke out, a great debate for those of you that are in our television audience that are members of the MEA, the Michigan Education Association. That's the one of the largest unions in the country. And there was a great debate that broke out among these members of this particular union, teachers union, and those who are pushing for change, transition, and for new paradigms in education. I say all that to say that there are those who take education seriously. Those who take it seriously hold their instructors and their school districts accountable, responsible for succeeding in instructing their children properly so that they can compete in the real world. Someone say real world. And this is how it is. If you didn't know it and had common sense, and I'm not trying to be disrespectful, but I'm simply speaking with harshness to some extent here, because we ought to have clear understanding that if we are in a church that we are not getting what we need in terms of the instruction of our spiritual academic development, that we may move from one level of development to the next, then what are we in that particular church for? Well, if you're going to sit there and criticize the church, then you have become a hypocrite. Because you are a hypocrite, because what are you doing there if the church is as bad as you say it is? Now, I have a practice here. My practice is a very simple one. If I hear that you're criticizing the church, I will call you into my office. And I will ask you, what is the problem? If the problem can't be solved, then I will tell you that we are happy to help you then move to the next level of remediation. That is, we will give you a letter